So you picked up a $5 keep key on Black Friday or some Monday sales, or maybe you pick them up for $10 by doing the KYC process on the Shapeshift exchange. But you're looking to set it up and maybe you haven't had a hardware wallet before. And I just thought I'd do a real quick video that steps through how to do that, because particularly for the keep key, I have found that can be a frustrating experience. And if you haven't already done so, hit subscribe, and that way you can stay in the loop about content I make to help you stay safe in a crazy and often hostile environment that is cryptocurrency. So this video basically will walk through the default process that's suggested by Keepkey and give attention to some of the roadblocks and shortcomings of their process they suggest, specifically struggles to get this to be detected by Shapeshift, struggles to be able to get the Keepkey client, the Chrome app, to load any wallets at all, and also the fact that there is no part of their procedure where they get you to verify your seed phrase. If you find yourself getting really frustrated with the tools and you want to throw this in the bin and just give up, I've actually created a separate video that looks at how to set up your Keepkey using a mix of the Keepkey tools as well as the Electrum open source wallet, which can essentially bypass all of the frustrations in terms of the Shapeshift platform and hopefully to set this up in a way that lets it be a really competent, really secure and really capable wallet. So when you open the box for your Keepkey, you'll see it has instructions. You go to keepkey.com/get-started and it actually says that on the Keepkey as well. So let's give that a go. And when you do that, you get to this screen here. And I think it's worth saying, before you do anything else, you need to actually read through this to the bottom. Because basically, if you just click on this first instruction here, it will immediately take you to this screen here. And you'll go to click Pair Keepkey and nothing will happen. So you actually need to use this link down the bottom here before you do anything else. That'll take you to this screen and you can download the Keepkey updater. Ah, here we go. Update required. So we'll say update now. We'll say this Keepkey is new. Ready to update. Unplug the Keepkey and plug it back in while holding the button. All right, let's do that. So unplug. Hold down the button, plug it back in. Verify backup. Do you have your recovery sentence in case your keys are erased? This is a brand new one, so we don't have to worry about that. Preparing for update. Do not unplug. Firmware update complete. Please disconnect and reconnect. Software successfully updated. Isn't that lovely? Bootloader update complete. Please disconnect and reconnect while holding the button. Sure. Disconnect and let's reconnect with the button held. Firmware update mode. Update now. Do you have your recovery sentence? Yes. We don't need it because it's brand new. Firmware update complete. Please disconnect and reconnect. All right, now it wants to take us back to get started. Let's try again. Pair keep key. There it is, connect. Now, this is an important link here. It says to recover using a backup sentence, please use the Keepkey desktop client. If you absolutely cannot get this Shapeshift initialization thing going, I strongly recommend using the Keepkey client because I found it to be far more reliable in terms of detecting the Keepkey and setting it up. But we'll just go through this process because it's in beta and hopefully it's going to get better. So we want to label the Keepkey. So we'll just call this one Steve's Keepkey for now, and now we're going to choose a PIN number. So this is the PIN number that you use to access your Keepkey. You'll have to enter it in every time you connect the device, and I'd strongly recommend having a nice long PIN. So not just one digit, not 2, 3, or 4, but something more like 6 to 8. And the reason why you can have a nice long PIN is that if you forget the PIN, you can just recover the device from your seed phrase, and that's not a problem. But this provides a simple layer of protection to stop someone just picking up your Keepkey and spending your crypto. So you'll notice that it's got the numbers displayed on the screen of the device, and those numbers correspond to this layout pad here. So I'm just going to use the pin 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 for this demo. So I'll say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. choose pin. Now we have to type it again just to make sure it's the same. You'll notice all the numbers have moved around on the keep keys screen. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We say confirm. Now, this is an important set of warnings that you really need to understand. So firstly, your recovery sentence is your one and only backup. It is the single most important backup. It is your wallet. Your recovery sentence is the most important piece of your security here. So your device came with a recovery sheet with it. So you'll notice it's got the spaces on here for the numbers, 1 to 12. And basically, you're going to write the 12 words down on there. Now, it's important that you write these down clearly on here because you will need to use this backup from time to time. Eventually, this device will fail. It's only a matter of time. Even if that takes 10 years and you'll need to use this. You need to keep this secure, and it's also worth doing it in something like a pencil because a pencil is less likely to fade than a pen. In terms of security, this is also something you should do without someone sitting over your shoulder watching you, without the webcam on your camera watching you, not in a public place. You know, do this in a private place, do this in a quiet place where you can focus, where you can write the things down clearly. And you'll notice that the sheet also is a nice hard piece of card because you don't want to just leave an impression of what you have written on the surface that you wrote your seed words on, because anyone who has these words can steal all of your crypto. It also has some really common mistakes. So don't just take a photo of it with your phone and think that you're fine. You'll also never need to save it to your computer or type it in on a website. Most scams that target users of hardware wallets will trick you into entering it on your computer. And don't just save it in a text file on cloud storage or upload to the internet. So there you go. So these warnings are really, 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 really important. This is the most important step in the creation of your wallet. So we're gonna say, get my backup. Now, this is where we need to pay close attention to what's on the screen. And we can see it gives us all the warnings again there. So we press this button and then our recovery phrase will appear. So we're going to write it down nice and clearly. So once you have written it down, you really need to double check it. So my suggestion for double checking at this point is just to reread it again from top to bottom and make sure they're the same. It's also worth just reading from bottom to top. So just to read them out of order to, again, try and avoid the little mental shortcuts that your brain might take in reading. And the other thing you can do to force your brain to take less mental shortcuts is actually to read the words letter for letter backward. That's something that you'll find actually helps you to be more careful in transcribing letter for letter the right word and noticing errors. So once you've got that transcribed, you can press the button. And again, really, really make sure you do this, because once you press this button, you will not see this seed phrase ever again. All right. Now your wallet is ready to go. And again, wonderful keep key has just said, whoops, there's an error. Let's just say retry and see what happens. But we've already set the wallet up on here now. So even if it says there's an error on the screen, that doesn't actually matter. So we'll just repair that. Oh my goodness. So this is the Shapeshift interface, and as you can see, we're connected to it, it's ready to go, and it's able to work as both an exchange and a wallet. However, before you use this as a wallet, there's a really important step from your setup that, in my opinion at least, KeepKey completely skips that you need to do. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to close Shapeshift. We'll come back to that later. So we're going to use the KeepKey client. That was the one off the Chrome store, because it has a really important feature that is completely missing from the interface that you see in Shapeshift. So we're going to close this ad because it's just trying to push us to Shapeshift, because everything about KeepKey wants to push us to Shapeshift. Now, the thing you might find, which I found, is that your KeepKey wallet, this is the Chrome app, might get stuck there saying loading accounts. And it might sit there forever. I've tried this on three separate computers and several different internet connections, and that often will get stuck and never ever load. So I jumped on Reddit and found that people had been having this issue actually all the way back to the end of 2017. And the workaround that some people had found was to actually have a VPN, even though here the support from KeepKey says, hey, you know, try not to use a VPN, try not to use antivirus. But I found that I have to have a VPN running for it to work, and frankly, I don't have the time or inclination to fire up Wireshark and find out exactly why that is necessary. But either way, running a VPN to the United States makes this Keepkey client actually work. Once you're in this screen, you need to click on this little cog here. And what we want to do is test the recovery sentence. This is a really important step that every other serious wallet manufacturer on the market makes you do. And it's to ensure that what you have written down is actually correct, because there is no second chance if you've stuffed this up other than using something like BTC Recover to try and identify the error in your phrase. So we're going to type in the PIN. Okay, so we're going to do a dry run recovery, and the instructions here are on the screen as well. And what we're going to do is, when we press and hold that button, what we get is what it calls a cipher. And what you can see is you've got a whole bunch of letters here along the top row, and then below in the gray box is the substitution that you will need to use to do this recovery with your Keepkey. The reason why we need this is so that you can use your keyboard to type in your recovery sentence in a way that someone who is recording and keylogging everything can't steal your seed and steal all your funds. So we're just going to type in all of these words. It is going to take a little while, but it's something that's really important to do to make sure you got this seed exactly right. And just to be really clear, for the first word ocean, I'll just read out what I'm typing as I type it in, and you'll see the letters change after every letter that I type. So for ocean, the first word, instead of O, I'm going to type B. Instead of C, I'm going to type T. Instead of E, I'm going to type V. Instead of A, I'm going to type R. And we can see that ocean has actually appeared on there, and that's correct. So we hit space, just because that's the way that we indicate that's the end of a word in Keepkey. So I'll just go through and do all these in and fast forward the video. And it's also worth saying that if the word you are looking for off your recovery phrase can't be found on here, then you have a typo in your word list. All right, so once we've typed in all 12 words, we can see the last one is there. We just say done. We can see that the seed is valid and matches the one in the device. That is what you need to see. If it says anything other than that, you need to run this again. And if you do it two or three times and it doesn't match, you need to reinitialize the device with a new seed. So once you have done this, then you are ready to go to start using your device. You need to securely store that somewhere. Don't just leave it lying around. Don't throw it in the bin. Don't burn it and try and memorize it. Securely store a copy of it somewhere. This piece of paper here is far more important than this hardware wallet here. This is your wallet. So if you're looking to store your seed phrase in something a bit more robust than a piece of paper, there are a few products that do that. You can get a cold tie, which is essentially a sheet of metal that you just stamp it into, or you can get a crypto steel, which basically comes with everything you need to essentially put it together like a puzzle, which just has the first four letters of each word in your phrase, which is all you need. There's also a newer option called a Kobo wallet, which is basically priced in between the two. And if you want to help me out in the process for either of those, I've got an affiliate link in the description. So we've installed the firmware, we've initialized our seed, and we've made sure that our backup is correct. So now we'll just have a quick look at how to use the Shapeshift interface to send and receive some transactions. So when you log in, you see this screen here, and the thing to notice is you don't actually need to create an account to do this. You only need to create an account if you want to like trade and things like that. So if you just want to use it as a wallet, you can just use this beta.shapeshift.com. You can bookmark that and use that as your wallet. So what we're going to do is we're going to say receive, and I'll just show you how we'd receive some Litecoin, for example. So you can see here it's shown me the QR code on the screen. But what I want to do is, if I'm actually giving this address to somebody else, I don't want to assume that my browser is not infected with malware or something like that. So I can actually click this Show on Wallet button, and I can verify that the Litecoin address that I'm seeing here exactly matches what I'm seeing on the screen. And the other thing that I can do is, if I'm wanting to send some Litecoin, I can actually just scan this QR code directly with Coinomi and then send the funds there that way. I can say, yes, that looks right. I can say, I'm just gonna send 1 cent on Coinomi. And there we go. So that transaction is sent on my phone now. And there we go. So that transaction has actually arrived just now, which is great. we can click out here and we can actually see the recent transaction now. So that's that Litecoin transaction that has arrived, which is great. And I'll just show you what it looks like to send. So if we go to send some Litecoin, we can scan the QR code that we want to send it to. Come on. And of course, it doesn't support SegWit on Litecoin, but anyway, so there's the account. And so I'll just say I want to send the maximum amount and I'll say continue. And then you can see the address that it's sending to appears on the keep key. And we want to verify that that is exactly the same address that I'm seeing here where it should be going, just to make sure that nothing has tampered with my wallet, that there's nothing dodgy going on my screen. And if that amount and the address is the same, we can say we want to sign that address. And it's confirming, do we want to send it? We'll say yes. And there we go. That is broadcasting the transaction. So using your Keepkey with Shapeshift is definitely one way that you can go about using your wallet. But the other thing you can do is you can actually use it directly with things like Electrum. And I'll cover that in a separate video. Thanks for watching. I hope that was helpful. Hit like if you think that other people would find this video useful, and hit subscribe if you'd like to be kept in the loop about future content I make that helps people stay safe in the crypto space and to recover if they get into trouble. If you have any questions about this video or a topic that you'd like me to cover, just leave a reply.